Did you know that having a baby due during the holidays actually increases your birth risk, not only for this pregnancy, but also for every baby you plan on having in the future? If you're due with a baby between Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's week, you definitely want to listen to today's video, because today we're going to talk about things you need to start considering now if you're due with a baby during the holidays. But before I begin, my name is Midwife Kira, and I believe in truly natural birth because I know it makes for better birth experiences. Consider subscribing to my channel and joining in today's conversation about holiday due date pressures. This is part one of my two-part series. Today we're going to talk about pressures from your physician and other birth options. When you have a baby due during the holidays, obviously there's added pressure and stressors on your plate. Everyone's planning celebrations, families coming in from out of town, family get-togethers and such. And when you're trying to juggle all of this, you're not only having to figure out all these typical holiday due date issues, but you're also having to figure out how you're going to handle this either heavily pregnant or with a brand new newborn baby. The fact is, it seems like everyone is making plans during the holiday except for your baby. In addition to your schedule, many mamas are having to take into consideration their doctor's schedule. I mean, doctors have families too, right? So it's not uncommon during the holidays that if your due date falls the week of their planned holiday vacation, that you're going to find yourself being offered an elective induction or possibly even an elective C-section simply because you're due with a holiday baby. And as you can imagine, after spending 8 or 9 months with this doctor, it's almost impossible to imagine them not being a part of your birth experience. And obviously, this can add more stress onto your plate. Before making any decisions during this holiday season regarding your birth, I really want you to know a couple of these things in advance. Number one, applying unnecessary risk to a healthy, low-risk pregnancy actually increases your risk to your birth, yourself, and your baby. Risks such as increased pain, hemorrhaging, uterine rupture, infection, surgical delivery, obviously a C-section, and not to mention other things like trauma and postpartum PTSD. Number two, each intervention that you apply to your birth carries its own risks. And sometimes we have to apply other interventions to help with those risks. And even more, sometimes it kickstarts the snowball effect of having to apply even more interventions to reduce those risks. And next thing you know, you're in the middle of what we call the snowball effect of interventions that leads to either poor birth outcomes or an unwanted C-section that may not have happened had we not initially applied those unnecessary interventions. The snowball effect is a term that has actually been coined by the business of being born. And if you haven't seen it, I'm going to go ahead and put a link to it in the description below. But basically, this is a snowball effect of interventions like I just described that ends up giving you birth outcomes that you did not desire simply by applying unnecessary interventions to your birth. And I hope that after watching today's video, you don't fall into this trap of these unnecessary interventions giving you birth outcomes that you would not have otherwise have desired. Number three, your future birth options depend on this birth, believe it or not. And so don't let this be one of those, in hindsight, I wish I would have done it different. Many, many women come to me desiring a VBAC because they didn't feel like they took advantage of the true options or birth options in their first birth. And now they can no longer have the option to have a vaginal birth outside of the hospital, or in many places, in Louisiana specifically, but throughout the country, VBAC's not even an option that is available. And don't let this be you. It's one thing to have a C-section when you need it. It's another thing to fall into the trap of the snowball effect that ends up with a C-section unnecessarily. And sometimes it doesn't even always end up in a C-section. I have women who come to me saying that they had desired an out-of-hospital birth, but because their first birth or their last birth went so poorly, such as needing a vacuum extraction to deliver the baby, or a broken clavicle, or the baby in NICU, that they believe that out-of-hospital birth is not a safe option for them because of what happened previously. And to be honest, this is simply not true. Again, this is where the snowball effect comes in. So be sure to not fall into that trap. What are some things you can do with a holiday due date baby to help your birth plans go right? Number one, ask lots and lots of questions. What are the benefits? What are the risks? Do I need this intervention or is it simply for convenience? Is it a Friday afternoon? Is it a Monday morning? Do I have time to think about it? Is it necessary? Who's the doctor on call if you're not available? What's that doctor on call C-section rate? Ask lots of questions. This is going to help you decide whether or not this intervention is worth the risks and the benefits. Number two, I want you to consider the Lamaze 6 Health Healthy birth practices. I actually shot a video on that with our local Lamaze instructor, Stephanie Trosclair, and I'm gonna go ahead and post a link to that video in the description below. These 6 healthy birth practices will help you achieve your best birth, and I really want you to consider them before you fall into the trap of having a holiday due date and all of its pressures. So I've said it before and I'm gonna say it again. As a midwife, I believe in truly natural birth because I know that it makes for better birth experiences. Now, they may not be the most convenient birth experiences, as I often do my job at 2 a.m. and on Saturdays and on weekends, but they're better. And why is that? Because for low-risk, healthy women, the less that you do to a birth that is working, the safer it is. So I hope that after watching this video, you don't fall into that category of, epidemic of American women who experience higher risks during their birth experiences simply because their baby is due during the holidays. My suggestion to you is, let your baby pick his or her own birthday. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, be sure to do that because next week I'm gonna talk with you about how to deal with holiday due date pressures with your friends and your family because I know that's a big deal too. If you have any questions, go ahead and post them in the comments below. Otherwise, I want you to follow me right here to the Lamaze 6 Healthy Birth Practices video because I know it's gonna help you have your best birth. Thanks for watching this Midwife Monday. Bye-bye.